Stewart.
And welcome to our channel. Now, before I will talk about the costs of being an actor, I would like to say first and foremost that if you find this offensive, piss off. Second of all, I have quite a few agents and all of them agreed with me that nobody should work for free, especially not the actors. I think acting is very admirable. I think acting is amazing and we all have to be crazy. Like, if you want to be an actor, you gotta be crazy because it is such an unstable job and a career, and it's, you're mentally have to be insane to in order to pursue it, which I kind of am. Now, I got all of that out and let's get started, I guess. So where I am at, I am paying for rent about 1500 plus utilities. For a lot of actors, especially in markets like LA and New York, rent is gonna be through the roof. I feel like it's way more expensive than it should be, but that's just me. Car, let's start with car insurance. So car insurance is gonna be, depends what kind of model of car you have. So I'm with State Farm. I have a car that's older than me, so it drives really well. And I pay about, I actually paid $150 a month. So, and I used to have a 2021 Honda Civic Sport, and I paid more than $300 in car insurance. So the rates may vary. Car itself, you, again, depends what kind of car you have. I bought the car for like $3,200. That's it. With my previous car, I paid $30,000 in one go because I was like, you know what? I don't want the credit to build up, so, and I want to pay it all and be done with it. But most people should pay a monthly fee of like, I think it's like $200-$300. Depends on the car you have. So, gas is not cheap. I know in California it's like $6 something. Here in the South, it's about $3.29, $3.50, depends where you go, but it's about, I would say average is like $3.50. Makeup for women is not cheap either. It's actually quite expensive. I mean, I have like eyeshadows from years, which is not very healthy, but I'm like, hey, the only things I am buying constantly are nail polish and eyeliner and mascara, and that's about it. So that costs about $20 and more. I'm so bad with clothes. I have so many clothes of all the like the different styles. Most of it is sexy and comfortable. So I'm becoming older and I'm gathering more like stylish and comfortable instead of sexy and uncomfortable. So clothes are not cheap. I order mine from Amazon because I can always return it if it's not the right size or texture, or if it looks horrible on me. So I would say clothes monthly, it's like $30 a month. Classes. I had some classes that started off with $150 and went up to $300 per class. So they vary. They definitely vary, but I would say 150 plus. Headshots, depends with who you are. I paid for some really good headshots, about 150 as well, $200. And they were nice headshots. So depends where you go, that's how much you pay. If not more. I know some headshots, they cost $1,000. Camera equipment. Right now the camera I'm using cost me about $700, and the lights, they were about $50, I would say, but I had them for like 4 or 5 years now, and I use them for everything. I use them for video blogs, I use them for auditions, I use them for other stuff, and yeah, $50, that's about it. So yeah, just go to Amazon, there's some really good ones. Background. I got this particular background for $20-$30. I can't even remember because that's how cheap it was. If you want to use like a cloth from Walmart, that shouldn't be too expensive. Green screen, and on the other side is blue screen, then you can find on Amazon. If you do not have camera equipment, you can go to taping services. They start off with $10 per 10 minutes and then they go up. Some charge an hourly fee, so just do your research. And but I would really suggest getting your camera equipment, because if you have an audition that's due tomorrow at 6 a.m, definitely get a camera, because it's most likely the taping services would be booked. Books about acting. they did not cost a pretty penny either. I have lots of books that I have read and then they just keep piling up on my shelf. So they start off with $25. If you are filming a demo reel, those services are not cheap either. Yeah, they cost a good money too. For my taping, I paid like $200 or so. But most of the footage that I used for my demo reel was from a TV show, and a few of them were from student films. The websites, Actors Access, 800 Guests, and IMDb Pro, they all vary in prices. So for Actors Access, it's $60 a year, which is totally worth it. You can submit for as many roles as you like. There should be 2 free photos that come with it. And also for each additional photo you pay $5, and for each clip I think you pay $11. IMDb Pro for yearly it's like 170 if not more. And 800 Casting, Casting Networks, Casting Frontier, they all are pretty pricey as well. So for all of those I would say spend at least $500. If you have your own website, for mine I use Wix. I'm probably gonna switch to other more affordable platform because I pay about $800 a year, which is, it's not bad, but it's also not really good because I have other website and I use Weebly and I pay like, I would say $20 a month, and it's not the best website, but it's very affordable. Memory cards cost $25 for one memory card. Also, electricity that I'm using right now, which is included, it's not included in my rent, but I pay about $80 a month. Laptop, I paid for my Mac. It was reimbursed, so it was like less than $1,000. It was a really good price. Yeah, internet costs, so I use AT&T and it cost me about $60, $70 a month, so yeah. Also, lodging, if you are traveling to the location and they're not paying, which is a big no-no, you would expect to pay somewhere from $120. So those are the most important things, and it's a very expensive hobby and it's a very expensive career to be an actor and to pay all of those things. And then people will tell you, oh yeah, we're not paying you for this project, we're only paying copy credit meals, which I think is bullshit. It costs more than $20,000 basically a year to be an actor, and like I was saying, it's a very expensive hobby, it's a very expensive career, but with every investment there does come a reward, there does come money. So always take part of the projects that actually pay, and they pay really good. Like for myself, if it's not for television or anything, if it's not union, I ask for at least $300 because it took me a while to get where I am. I am SAG eligible, but I'm willing to work on non-union and SAG projects, so which is like good. It's like, yes, I booked my first co-star, and because I was naked in that part, I did get paid about $1,000, so which I was like, okay, yeah, of course you gotta pay me so I can be naked, like of course. Same with body double. I loved being a body double, and I got paid $7,500. And I'm still getting residuals from that. And that was like 5 years ago, back in 2019. So, yay, residuals. It's not a lot of residuals. That's why the strike started. Well, one of the reasons, but yeah. Always pay your actors. And one of my agents, she said, those filmmakers, they prey on actors' ego because they're like, we really need you. Unfortunately, we can't pay you for this project, but you're the best. And I'm like, yeah, they really do like prey on the actors' egos because us actors, we have very fragile egos. Not me, like I don't give a shit, but a lot of other actors. So yeah, never take part of the projects that are free because like, what are you gonna get? Shitty footage if you're even gonna get footage. So guys, hustle and never work for free, because it's like the same as coming in as an accountant and working in the office all day for free. So why should it be the same for actors? But yeah, thank you so much for listening to my rant and whatnot, and yeah, stay cool and whatnot, and I will talk to you guys next time.